Hi, I'll show you how to install Windows 11 on a 2018 Intel-based MacBook Pro. Right now, I'm running the latest Sequoia update. My Mac, however, only has 256GB of storage, which makes installing Windows on the internal drive possible, but not very practical. Luckily, there's a way to install Windows on an external USB drive instead. Many guides out there suggest using virtual machines, but those can often cause issues on a Mac. In my case, I ran into problems with my Samsung T5 drive. So, I found a simpler method to install Windows 11 directly onto it, without needing a virtual machine. Before I show you how to do it, note how simple it is to use Windows this way. When you start your Mac, just press the Option key on your keyboard and select your external Windows drive as your startup disk. Windows 11 starts up quickly and loads faster than macOS. It's true that Apple officially supports only Windows 10, but there's no issue installing all the drivers needed for Windows 11 to function properly. Everything works. The touch bar, keyboard, Wi-Fi, and GPU, once the full driver package from Apple is installed. Interestingly, an eGPU with the latest NVIDIA 4000 series also works, which I demonstrate in another video. You can find the link in the description. One small caveat. You'll need a wired USB mouse during the Windows 11 installation. If, like me, you have a USB-A mouse, you'll also need a USB-C adapter or hub. I use one from GreenCell, and it works great. Once the drivers are installed, you won't need the mouse anymore. Let's begin. First, you need to change your Mac's security settings to allow it to boot from USB. To do this, turn off your Mac. When turning it back on, press and hold the Command and R keys until the startup options appear. Log into your administrator account and enter the password. Choose Utilities, then select Startup Security Utility. You'll need to enter the administrator password again. Okay, now just two clicks and you're done. Set Allow Booting from External Media and select No Security. Then, restart your Mac. In the next step, you'll need to download the Windows installation files, the Rufus app to install Windows on an external drive, and the drivers from Apple. You can download the Windows 10 and 11 ISO files from the official Microsoft website. You can download Rufus from the official website of the developer. Now you just need to download the drivers from Apple. In this case, open Bootcamp Assistant app. Click on Action and select Download Windows Support Software. Save the file. The download may take some time, depending on the availability of Apple servers. I have noticed that sometimes this process can hang without any notification, so you may need to retry the download. Once you have downloaded everything, you can proceed to the next step, where you will format your external drive. Open the Disk Utility app. Then, connect your external drive. If you don't see all the partitions as shown here, you can easily adjust this in the View settings. Unmount the disk partition and format it in exFAT format. exFAT will only be needed to copy files between Mac and Windows, as it is a format that is compatible with both operating systems. If this process fails, make sure you have not selected the entire disk instead of a single partition. Okay, we have all the files and the drive prepared. Now, we can copy the Windows 11 ISO file, the drivers, and Rufus to the external drive. In the next step, we will create a boot camp partition where Windows 10 will be installed, but only to enable the installation of Windows 11 on external media. I know it sounds strange, but believe me, this process is much faster and easier compared to other methods. That's why you need 60 GB of free space on your Mac's internal drive, and it's very important to make a backup of your system at this point. To move forward, you need to unmount and physically detach the drive from the USB-C port. Then open Bootcamp Assistant. Click Continue. You will receive a notification that Secure Boot is disabled. That's okay, we had to disable it ourselves. Select the ISO file for Windows 10. Then, just click Install. After a while, the system will automatically restart and boot into the Windows 10 installation process. Complete the entire setup procedure. Right after the installation, a window will appear prompting you to install the drivers from Apple. You can skip this step, as it's not necessary for our target system. Now you can reconnect the external drive and copy all the files from it. Open the Rufus app. First, expand Advanced Options and check List USB Hard Drives. External Drive will appear automatically. Then, select the Windows 11 ISO file. Expand Image Options and select Windows to Go. Then, you can also rename the volume label. Click Start. You can choose the Windows version whenever you like. Next, select the other options to facilitate installation, then click OK. The application will completely format your external drive and prepare it for installing Windows 11. If you tried creating multiple partitions before, unfortunately, everything will be wiped. But don't worry, after the installation, you'll still be able to set up partitions, which is useful if you want to share files between macOS and Windows using a single external drive. I show how to do that in another video. You can find the link in the description. When the process is complete, you need to copy the Apple drivers to the newly created partition. Then, reboot the system. During startup, press and hold the Option key. Select EFI boot. Now, at this point in the installation of Windows 11, you will need a wired mouse. Click I don't have internet and go through the entire installation process. Fortunately, it's streamlined to the essentials. Okay, you're almost done. The last thing you need to do is install the Apple drivers. Open Bootcamp Windows support from the external drive. In this case, you will need to locate it where you previously copied it on the drive. Then, open the setup file and install drivers. Great, everything is ready. From now on, you have Windows 11 on the external drive. After installing the drivers, Windows will automatically restart. You can now use Windows just like it was installed on the internal drive. But let's return to macOS for a moment to delete the bootcamp partition. Open Disk Utility app and unmount external drive with Windows 11. Physically disconnect the drive. Open Bootcamp Assistant app. Click Continue and Restore. Then enter the password. Now you have restored the entire internal storage for macOS only. You can use Windows whenever you need it without sacrificing your internal storage. Switching between systems is easy, just hold the Option key when turning on your computer. That's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.